I guess now I know why Mom didn't like me playing with the music box. Funny, all those times I played with the music box and never found the basement key. Edie told me once that every Finch who ever lived is buried somewhere in the library. Mom said the basement was off limits, unless I wanted another tetanus shot. I saw Edie sneak down to the basement once, carrying packages. I thought maybe she was hiding presents. It turned out she was hiding a lot more than that. I remember asking Mom once about where Walter had gone. She said after Barbara died, he got as far away as he could. If there's a pattern in all these stories, I think it's that none of us has gotten very far.
Goodbye, everyone. I can't believe I've been down here for 30 years. On that first day, after the shaking started, I didn't think I'd survive a week. But after a few days, I settled into a routine. That's what kept me sane. Having a schedule, living for today. I always expected to be dead tomorrow. But if you wait long enough, you get used to anything. Even a monster on the other side of the door starts to feel normal. Almost friendly. And then one day, everything just stopped. Thank you. Whatever that thing was, it was gone. Maybe it got tired of waiting. Or maybe I just got tired of being afraid. It's been a week now, the longest in 30 years. I'm done waiting. I have to leave while I still can. I know it's out there, somewhere. Whatever killed Barbara. And Molly. And Calvin. Maybe this is all a mistake. But I need to stop living the same day, even if it kills me. Whatever's out there, I want you to know I'm ready for it. I'm going to appreciate all of it, especially the food. I don't mind if I only have a year left. Or a month. Or a single week. I'd be happy with one new day. I can already imagine the sun on my face.
Walter died when I was 6. I can't believe my mom never told me he was down here. I'm sure my mom was trying to protect me. Maybe she was afraid I'd end up like Walter. But if she never told me about an uncle under the house... I can only imagine what else she was hiding. I don't want to make the same mistakes she made. Trying to bury something that's still alive. Now that there's only one of us left, or maybe two, I thought it was time I heard the stories for myself and found out what happened to everyone else. But now I'm worried the stories themselves might be the problem. Maybe we believed so much in a family curse, we made it real. I don't know if I should even be writing this. Maybe it'd be better if all this just died with me. But I thought you should know about your family. And the history you're a part of. Though, to be honest, I feel as lost as you probably do right now. I think the people in these stories believed them, for what that's worth. And when you look at the house, at that history of imagination and stubbornness and madness, any of it seems possible. I think we've been surrounded by death for so long, we've just gotten used to it. What kind of family finishes building a cemetery before starting the house? It's embarrassing for me to admit this, but the pet cemetery made me more uncomfortable than the human one. Three of the gerbils were mine, and two had been my fault. Sven built the house, but it was Edie who designed the cemetery. I'm sure Odin's monument had been Edie's idea. My mom was always trying to move on, but for Edie, the past never went away. You could see it poking out of the water at low tide. Edie said she dreamed about the old house every night. Edie's side was always easier for me to understand. But the older I get, the more I can see where my mom was coming from. She lost two of her brothers, just like I did. I get why she tried so hard to protect us. There's so many things I wish I could ask my mom now. Part of me thinks this is what she wanted all along. For me to come back someday and find everything out for myself. But looking back on it now, if she told me there was going to be so much climbing, I never would have come when I was 22 weeks pregnant. I never met Grandpa Sam, but I think he and my mom had a lot in common. They were both pretty intense. Instead of hiding from death, Sam seemed to go out of his way to meet it.
Dawn, I promise. You'll never forget this weekend.
Yes, sir.
These memories are going to last a lifetime.
Mm-hmm. Am I going to have to shoot anything?
It's a hunting trip, Dawn. Shooting is strongly encouraged.
What?
Perfect.
It's gonna rain the whole weekend, isn't it? Please just take the damn picture.
Hey, language.
Want to get a picture of me or what? I will never forget this weekend, Dad.
That's the spirit. Okay, got it.
I'm gonna take some pictures, okay?
Just be careful. The camera's older than you are.
You're right, Dad. It's starting to clear up. Still freezing, though.
Definitely should not have drunk all that coffee.
Hold still while I take a picture of you.
I definitely won't be moving.
Are you done yet?
Does it sound like a... Hey!
That's a keeper.
I'm just saying, I'm not always going to be here, Don. You'll need to remember this stuff if you want to survive.
I'll be fine, Dad.
You know who else thought he was going to be fine?
Some guy who died.
Dawn, I'm being serious.
I know, Dad. You're always serious. Doesn't being out here make you want to chill out?
Well, to tell you the truth, I haven't been out here in 20 years. Dawn, don't you think you could find something more interesting to photograph? Last time I was with my brother Calvin. Man, that was a great trip. Your grandpa Sven taught us how to fish, how to build a fire. We found an old logging trail. There were deer everywhere. I bet if I could remember where that trail was, we'd spot a buck for you in no time. Give me a minute to check the map.
Dad!
Good eyes, Dawn. Before you take the shot, let me get a picture of you.
Dad, I...
Just breathe. Let me get behind you.
Do I have to do this?
Dawn, you don't have to do anything. But if you want to survive, you'll need to be strong. Great shot, Dawn! I'm proud of you, Dawn. Always remember that, okay? Sorry, Dawn. Just gotta reset the timer. Hang on, kiddo. Just trying to get a shot of the two of us together.
Dad, it's twitching. I think
it's totally normal, Dawn. Just focus on the camera. Try not to think about
it. Dad!
Of all these stories, that's the one I wish most that my mom had told me.